Hello, it's Miles Austin coming to you today with an unbelievable new AI tool for graphics. It's something that I've never seen before. I'm sure you haven't either. Brand new, not even available yet. It'll be available probably right after, possibly right before the 4th of July weekend here in the States. But let me show you what this does. The concept of this is pretty straightforward. We all have the ability to conjure up an image in our head, something that we can imagine that we'd like to see, whether it's something you need for social media or a book or an article or a blog post, whatever it might be that you're needing a graphic for, maybe a logo, very honestly. And what you want to do is you want to be able to take the image in your head and turn that into a drawing, a piece of art, a photo. Well, that's never been able to be done before until now. So here's what happens. This tool is going to give you the ability to sketch out really rough draft sketch on your computer screen using only your mouse, sketch out a scene, and describe very briefly what it is that you're seeing in your mind and translate that into an image. Watch what's going to happen. Let me describe what it is. I'll go type it in first. I'm seeing a mountain scene with a, whoops. There we go, mountain scene with a river flowing into a lake. Okay, nothing too difficult, a mountain scene with a river flowing into a lake. So now watch what's going to happen here. I'm going to sketch it out using only my mouse. All right, and you'll see real quickly I am not an artist in any way, stretch, or form. Okay, so let's put a little snow on a couple of these. Okay, and let's say then that we have a river maybe coming right down here, flowing into this lake that I see in my mind. You can kind of tell where my mind is today. And it's flowing down into a lake. I see in my mind kind of a crystal clear, beautiful blue water lake. Okay, that's it. A mountain scene with a river flowing into a lake. Now, if you look at that, and no crude comments as I look at it now, but if you look at that, that's about as crude as you can get, gang. So what happens is you choose the fidelity, and I'm going to use this in a way just to demonstrate to you the power of this. But fidelity, that little slider down below right here, is just how much detail and how elaborate you want to be. I'm going to leave it at 5. And I'm going to click draw. And your sketch on the left is now turned into the sketch on the right. Well, that's not bad, but you're going to say, Miles, that's not that impressive. You're right. So if I scroll it up to number 6, and normally you wouldn't go this slow. I'm just doing it for demonstration purposes. Look at that. From 5 to 6, look at the difference in that drawing. There actually is something there. I know what that is now. If I go up from 6 to 7 and click draw, Now I'm onto something. Now they're getting the idea of what I see in my mind. I love the blue colors and the shadows. It's definitely there. I could probably use that as it is for a lot of purposes, but if I scroll it up to an 8 and click draw, now you got it. Look at that. Look at the lake down there, the beautiful mountains. Beautiful. Go up to 9, click draw. Oh, I mean, I could never ever create something like that. That's just stunning. If I go all the way up to 1, click draw, look at that. That's just nuts. I mean, I'm sorry, but it's just nuts. If that's what you want, you click download. If you want to refine it, I'll show you that in a moment. I'm going to go down to number 8, I think it was. Look at that. That's just crazy how cool that is. Okay, and now again, I can click that and download it if I want to. But let me show you what happens on any of these images. If you click refine, AI is going to take some magic dust and sprinkle it over and kind of clean it up. Look at this. Look at that. It's just stunning compared to the image and the sketch, crude sketch, on the left. Okay? So let me do one more real quick for you to show you the power of this. I like keeping it on 4 or 5 just to show you the dramatic transformation. What I'm going to do is I'm going to create an image of a woman, long flowing hair. Okay, and she's sitting at a desk and she's typing on her computer. Okay, there's her other hand. And you'll notice I'm not having to worry how many fingers does she have any other. I'm not worried. I'm just getting a sketch. I want to get out of my mind what I see onto paper, if you will, in this case. And here she's sitting at a desk. Okay, and maybe then her legs come down below and she's got her legs out like this. Okay, so that's great. Woman sitting at a desk and she's typing on a computer. Again, pretty rough. Now realize I'm typing, I'm sketching this using my mouse and I'm actually using a rollerball, so it's not even probably as easy and as accurate. As I'm just putting some keys. I don't even really need to do much of these. I'm just doing it for my own gratification here. Okay. So now what I need to do is d delete my last message and say, woman sitting at desk typing on computer. Okay. So it is woman sitting at a desk typing on a computer. You can see, you'll have to agree, that's as, probably as crude as you're going to get. Well, watch this. I click on it. It refines it a little bit. If I go up to five, let's go up to five, just to show you the progression if you want to. They definitely, it's got the idea. Look at that. Look at that. It just blows my mind. Oh, look at the sketch on the left and now the sketch on the right. Eight, nine. Nine's pretty darn good. And then 10 might be too much. Yeah. See, I'm not sure I like quite that far, personally. It's just personal taste, but that one's not bad. Now, watch this. One of the things I haven't shown you. So this is a sketch on the left of a woman at a desk typing on computer. Come on. There's no way I can ever create what you're looking at. Perfect for a lot of uses. Now watch the button on the right. When I really want to get some magic fine-tuning and really crisp it up, whatever the image is that you select, I can either obviously download it now, or I can also click refine and watch what happens to that image. Wow. Right? It just really tightened it up. Now, very honestly, I personally like the other one better. Okay? So let's go back here. Let's click draw. And I'm back to nine to eight, it looks like. Yeah. Okay, so I would download that photo and I'm good to go, guys. I think that's beautiful. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this. I hope it stimulates your thinking. Man, what could I do with this? As I said, especially if you're not a creative person, I have one of my clients the other day. We were playing with this, and we created a logo that was just awesome. And I thought, you know, there's so many things you could do with this tool if you just have the ability to sketch out what's in your mind and let it do the hard work to create an image for you. So, if you like what you see or you want to learn more, just keep an eye at Fill the Funnel. Keep an eye on our Facebook page. Keep an eye, if you're a subscriber to our newsletter, you'll get this information on how to go find it, check it out, learn more. We're going to price this really low because I really want to get this in everyone's hands. It's really a cool tool that you can play with. Keep an eye out for it. It'll be out within a few days of the 4th of July weekend before. It might be out on Wednesday, but tomorrow, but I got a few things I need to get wrapped up with it first. So, keep in touch. I'd love to know your thoughts. Tell me what you think in the comments below. Bye.